Hey Jasmeet.
What's up, Manus? What are you showing me today?
Remember in the last game how Lara Tomb Raider Rose?
And this now time, she's so high, we can only see her shadow.
Yes, she's casting long shadows this time around.
Nice.
This is Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the final part in the Tomb Raider reboot origin story trilogy.
So this is going to be the last game. We're done with Tomb Raider, the reboot series.
Yeah, the reboot is done, I think. I think wherever they go next, it'll... She's now a full-fledged Tomb Raider.
Okay,
the origin is done. She's now a Tomb Raider.
Rebooted well though.
I think this game is pretty good.
Okay.
Like, it has its flaws. It does some things very well. The key being the exploration. As you can already see, the environments look beautiful. And because they look so beautiful and they're so filled with detail, it is a lot of fun to explore and discover stuff, solve puzzles and do everything that is related to exploration. The combat is... Combat takes a big backseat in this game.
That's a really dense jungle though.
Yeah, it is
as
very
dense. To the tomb.
And then these tombs, like everything is very detailed, very elaborate. Also exploring, like every tomb takes like 10 to 15 minutes to get through. All of them are pretty massive.
No, but is it because you're slow at solving puzzles or is it because...
It's a mix of both. I'm not saying ki my tomb raiding skills are the best, but I try. So iska story is, I'll talk about the story a little bit. The story is not that good. The story is not that good because aisa lagta hai ki na, there is a lot of weight given to a lot of... Okay, paladins, always important to remember. Update is installed. There iska story like, kaise bolu yaar, like it's not...
Use words. Coming into your mind.
That's true. They try to take it very seriously, but... The facial animations, all of it, like, it doesn't deliver on the story at
plus
all.
Plus, photo mode, you can make her smile in ridiculous situations.
That is true. That is always an option.
It's hard to take that seriously.
Yeah. But story aside, like, the story... I skipped almost all the cutscenes because after the first couple of hours, I realized, yeah, the story is going nowhere. And I didn't care about it at all. But I still kept playing because, as I said, the exploration is so much fun.
So was this on the PS4 or the PS4 Pro?
This is running, the footage that we're seeing right now, it's running on the PS4 Pro. I played it mostly on the base PS4 and I hardly noticed any difference. So, because the game looks great on both platforms, like base PS4 pe bhi badi hai and on Pro, it also looks amazing. This is me doing one of the bigger challenge tombs. So whenever you get to these tombs, you have to reach like a particular spot. If you reach that spot, that is like the end of that tomb and you get a permanent skill unlocked. Something like, you know, you take less damage from bullets or a variety of that. You do more damage, so stuff like that. So that's the end goal in these tombs. But even without those goals, like your end reward, it's still fun to explore.
Okay, but they're like the side missions.
So the tombs are kind of like the side stuff. But the tombs are, well, essentially the best part of the game.
That jungle looks amazing.
Yeah, it is. Like all of these environments, like everything is packed with detail. The water looks amazing, like the reflections, the way it ripples, all of it. And also the jungle is filled with both foliage and you can also see a lot of wildlife. You'll see smaller animals like rabbits and all scurrying around. Uske alawa, there'll be pigs and wolves. A lot of birds in the sky. So all of that looks...
Can you shoot the birds in the sky?
Well, I can. Yeah, I can. And you get extra skill points for shooting down eagles and stuff.
Shit, man. So, animal cruelty.
Yeah. Hey, did you remember this being in the previous games? Ye jo, like, you use your pickaxe.
Yeah, pickaxe.
And then you rappel down. I don't remember the rappelling down. I thought this was new in this game, but I'm not sure. But...
Uncharted mein tha.
Uncharted mein tha. So maybe that's where I'm remembering it from. But this rappelling and all, like, it gives you a good look of the environment that you're exploring. Like, when you rappel down these massive caves, the camera pans out a little bit. Like, it's very majestic.
Okay.
Everything, yeah. See, the combat is not that big of a focus. It works well. Jab hota hai, toh maza aata hai combat karne.
But hota nahi hai.
Jada hota nahi hai. But I think I kind of prefer that.
It's like my life, no? There's no action. But when it is...
It's good.
Yeah.
You come to appreciate it a lot more, I guess.
Yeah, but mostly no action.
Mostly no action. Chalta hai lekin that, like, you know, you take what you can get.
Yeah.
You hide in these bushes some of the times, like in real life. So, yeah, the combat is pretty standard third-person cover shooter.
Mm-hmm.
There are some new mechanics added, like Lara can now cover herself with mud and all to hide herself a little bit better from enemies. Some of the enemies in the later stages will have thermal vision, and also at those points it gets straight up like Predator type, na?
Oh, nice.
Like you putting, covering yourself with mud to avoid being detected and all.
Lara Croft becoming the Predator.
It's pretty much that.
That would make a cool movie though, you know? Lara Croft goes tomb raiding and there she meets the Predator.
Not a bad idea.
I should start writing this before somebody takes it.
Oh yeah, that's true. Don't say these ideas out loud on video, man. Come on.
Yeah.
So, and there are some set pieces like these. Set pieces are fine. Like, yeah, Uncharted, I think, has already done them better. So, isliye set pieces, they're good, but nothing really worth talking about. Uske alawa, what else is there? Stories and all that good. Graphics are amazing. Exploration is fun.
I have one very important question.
What's up?
Why does it seem like after every game, Lara Croft goes and gets a makeover?
I know, right? Like her face changes every time. But if you have a problem with that, they fixed it by giving you a skin that pretty much replaces her older face along with the older costume from the last games.
Plus, you can also unlock that older Lara Croft.
Oh, you can go way back. Like from the earlier Lara Croft games, you can unlock skins from
So fans can actually go and play as the original Lara Croft.
Yeah, those pixelated boobs, they still look good.
You take what you can get.
So yeah, like it's also there are big hubs in this game. Like there is a hub that you get to around 2 or 3 hours into the game, which is kind of small, but there is a lot of side stuff. So every hub you get to, it's like a zone in itself where you can explore, discover a lot of side missions, progress the main mission, as well as all the tombs and crypts and everything you can find there, and find collectibles.
So
and
how
all.
Many such hubs are there?
I have come across a total of 3, and I think that's it. Like early on, you get to a village which is near the forest and quite easily accessible.
Okay.
Later on, you get to a hidden village which is massive. Like there are underground tombs beneath waterfalls, underwater stuff, up in the mountains and everything. Later on, you get to another big village. I think that's a Christian village where you can talk to people and find more stuff. Like all of that stuff is done very well.
Lara Croft religious though.
I don't think so. Because she breaks everything she finds, though. I don't think she believes in everything. She either breaks everything she finds or she keeps it for herself.
Oh.
So, I mean, everything she sees, yeah, this would look good in my manner when I finally build it. So.
Okay. But yeah. I heard it's a story for something like Lara causes the end of the world. Lara starts the end of the world.
I think wo to hamesha se, that's been Lara Croft's
style.
Ki na, get to a place. She feels very emotional. Shit, man, what have I done? I've killed so many people. Bahut galat hua.
But then she goes and kills more
people. Yeah, cries for a bit, then kills like 50 more people. And then blows up the rest of the remaining buildings. So this time she said, you know what, this is the last. This probably is my last chance.
Yeah, because the devs are not making any more games. No?
I don't know.
Literally her last chance.
So maybe might as well destroy the whole world.
Exactly.
Go out with a bang. So. But yeah, the story is pretty nonsensical, like us way, na.
But it's good though. Her emotions don't get in the way of killing.
That's I think very important. Also, always remember, no matter where you are, deep in the jungles, in hidden villages that has never met civilization, you can always find automatic rifles from merchants.
Right to bear arms, man.
Always been
very
defended.
Important.
So yeah, the combat is like as easy as you want it to be, or you can make it be tougher. But since the combat wasn't
the way
the focus,
you've been playing the game, doesn't look that easy.
This is actually me playing this on easy because the combat wasn't the focus. I was mostly trying to do the puzzles and all.
That's why you play games on easy.
Yeah, that's mostly why. Even with puzzles, you can choose to
autoplay.
Not autoplay. Like with the white strips, nahi aate, markers that kind of guide you. So you can choose to disable them. But chakkar hai ki if you disable them, na, it gets so confusing as to where you need to go. There is no middle ground. You either have to follow the markers. You have to do a lot of trial and error, which is frustrating. So I just turned on all the markers. Bhai. Let me know where to go. I'll figure out the rest. So
what's there to figure out then?
Well, the puzzles still need to be done. You can also use the instinct mode. Nahi hota hai. When you push down, when you push down a button, everything you see highlights as to where you need to go or what's interactable. If you're in the middle of a puzzle and if you set it to easy, she'll give you the next step. Directly, she'll just say, yeah, do this next. So, again, it can be as easy or as tough as you want.
That's funny though.
But I will say one thing, man. I feel ki between Spider-Man and the upcoming Red Dead, Call of Duty and everything, this game is kind of getting lost a little bit. This game is very good. Like, exploration-wise, I am very happy playing this game. In fact, I stopped playing Spider-Man because I was having so much fun with this game.
Okay, so are you gonna start raiding tombs now?
I think after this, after I'm done with this, I'll find. Yahan pe India mein to kafi tombs hai. I'm going to Humayun's tomb with a pickaxe, and I'll try jumping off a building and see how it goes.
Nice.
I'll be sure to stream it out. Aajkal ke time mein.
Live stream, that makes more sense.
But yeah, once again, like, see these environments, like everything, because everything is so dense and packed with detail, and you want to look around every nook and cranny. Ki na, dekhna hai mujhe.
You
I want
to go exploring.
Yeah, you.
Hashtag wanderlust.
Wanderlust, yeah, that's exactly what she's hashtagging whenever she takes a picture.
Nice.
Also, like, isme wo, there's the same stuff like the language and all. Wo sara hai abhi bhi. Where you learn languages as you progress and then you can read monoliths and all. Na?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so those then lead to treasure and everything. So,
okay.
The same camp system is there. Like, I've just come across a camp where you can upgrade your skills and all.
Basically, like, you know, this is what makes it the Dark Souls of third person adventure games.
Yeah, you get to a bonfire, upgrade your skills, move on.
Exactly.
So yeah, in that way, it's the same, similar stuff. There are a lot of skills, but chakre, I didn't find any of the skills as critical or crucial.
You just quit the game. Why?
Yeah, I was like,
I'm done.
Oh yeah, that's it. Shadow of the Tomb Raider, good game. That's mostly what I had to say. Do you have any questions?
Live in the Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
Yeah, I think I'll be living in Lara's shadow for a while longer. I'll finish this game. This game is fun. I think I'll even do all the DLCs. DLCs, mein, they're adding more tombs and stuff, which honestly is, again, best part of the game, like exploring.
I mean, what is a Tomb Raider going to do without tombs?
Very true. Now that you said it, let's go raid some tombs. This game, easily, in my eyes, I think it caters to my taste. You know, I like these jungle environments a lot. So for me, it's a 9 out of 10.
So when are you moving out of the city?
Very soon. No, I like jungles in my video games. Baki to I need technology, man. I like the comfort of my own house. Let her do all the jumping and the raiding. And the shooting and the getting shot at.
Makes sense.
Alright guys, thank you for watching. If you like this video, be sure to hit like.
Subscribe.
Yes. Everything that he said. And catch all the other coverage that we do at gamingmonk.com. Bye guys.